Terror and mass hysteria have swept the nation as the most potent outbreak of love fever leading to sex mania in recent years is now reaching its most climactic peak. The government's chief medical officer, Bernard Jizzen St. John, has issued a statement that the condition has reached pandemic levels and that those who have contracted the disease must be kept isolated and in extreme cases, restrained. Love fever nurses have been posted at city centre hotspots around the country to offer the antidote to those with early onset of the disease. A woman who wishes to remain anonymous from Stroud has claimed to have needed to change her undergarments 38 times daily due to her unquenchable excitement. Contracted through the infected pheromones of carriers, love fever can be caught by simple inhalation of a carrier's perspiration, which is alarmingly irresistible. Government officials warn to stay indoors, and if you do have to go out, wear a love fever protection mask at all times. Once contracted, love fever symptoms progress to full-blown sex mania in a matter of moments. The breakdown of progressive symptoms are as follows. Perspiration of the upper lip. Rapid increase in temperature. Lustful thoughts. Permanently dilated pupils and a proclivity to wink suggestively at strangers. The ability to turn almost every sentence or phrase into a smutty innuendo. Undiscerning attraction to the opposite sex. Misunderstanding almost every statement made as a proposition for sex. Violently gyrating pelvic thrusts, which can go up to speeds of up to 194 kilometers an hour. Wandering hand syndrome. Leading to full sexual delirium with full public auto-stimulation. Please ensure that if you see anyone with what may be these symptoms, to alert your nearest love fever nurse or the authorities immediately. The condition is highly contagious, and without total vigilance, the country will descend into orgiastic Armageddon in a matter of weeks.
I'm not afraid to die.